Well, a little more than $1 billion. That's the current price on the new Vikings stadium, a figure that has gone up and up. Taxpayers are responsible for around $500 million of that.
And the clear roof of the new stadium will be a first for the NFL. So we decided to investigate. In fact, we spent 6 months researching, emailing, calling around to other facilities in places like New Zealand, and talking to the stadium decision makers here in Minnesota. 5 Eyewitness News morning anchor Chris Eggert even traveled to Germany to put the clear portion of the roof to the test. He found his size 12 shoes aren't the only challenges this roof could face.
What exactly is this stuff? You can bounce on it like a trampoline.
I have to get a good grip, actually.
Small strips of it are really hard to pull apart.
It's very strong.
It's shaped and stretched to build amazing things like Beijing's water cube at the 2008 Olympics.
The cube where Michael Phelps broke all those world records. It is amazing.
Yet it does have a breaking point. For the answer, we traveled to northern Germany. It's here in the city of Bremen, where a company called Vector Foiltec is preparing the sheets of polymer film called ethylene tetrafluoroethylene, or ETFE.
What's the lifespan on this material? How long can we expect the roof of this stadium to hold up?
Currently, we don't know the lifespan.
Vector Foiltec's founder and managing director, Stefan Lienert, says this is the first NFL stadium for his company.
We think it's one of the most significant jobs that we've done recently.
The clear section of the stadium roof currently only exists as a computer design. Once Vector Foiltec and the Viking Stadium architects, HKS, agree on a final plan, the designs will be drawn into sheets, cut out, and then sealed together in a process that they call welding. The deflated foils will be placed on a ship and eventually end up in Minnesota. It's here that they'll be attached to the stadium structure and inflated into cushions. A far cry from the Metrodome that once stood here, but important to point out the similarities. This is an inflated roof, despite the fact it's clear. While some wanted to see a retractable roof for the new stadium, this non-movable ETFE roof was a more cost-effective compromise. Michelle Kelm-Helgen is the chair of the Minnesota Sports Facilities Authority.
This building will be the largest section of ETFE anywhere in North America. It's going to have 250,000 square feet of ETFE in that roof. Our roof will be approximately 60% of it will be the ETFE.
What is the other half of the roof made out of?
It's basically a hard steel deck, essentially.
The design benefit that the architects discuss is that inhabitants of the building, you know, game viewers, can see this expansive view of the downtown skyline and the sky above. From a lot of vantage points in the stadiums.
Blaine Brownell, a University of Minnesota Associate Professor of Architecture, is excited about what the future holds for ETFE, even though he says there's not a great deal of research on the material.
The current estimates that I've heard are that ETFE is a 50-plus year material. The plus is a big question mark, and certainly that doesn't account for extreme climates or disasters or events that we might experience.
Disasters like the Metrodome collapse in 2010.
Can you guarantee that this is going to hold up in the snow?
Yeah.
Yet Lienert admitted in the 2008 book ETFE Technology and Design to snow problems that they encountered with Allianz Arena in Munich.
In Allianz Arena, the solution is to shovel off the snow. Our strategy is when you have major snow loads, you don't want to deal with shoveling snow off the roof.
They sent people up on the roof to get the snow off, and you...
We don't like that.
Is there a scenario where that could happen with the Viking Stadium?
I can't imagine it.
Lienert says that Vector Foiltec wasn't intimately involved with the design of Allianz, a mistake that they won't make again, and said that they did work with architects and structural engineers on the new Vikings stadium.
Is there a warranty on snow?
We basically over-designed the roof by far. So, and as long as we stay within these engineering limits, yes, there's a warranty on the product.
After our interview with the head of the company, Vector Foiltec asked me to climb up on a mock-up of the stadium roof to see its strength for myself. We put the new Viking Stadium to the ultimate test. 6'4", 210 pounds of reporter taking approximately 92 pretty big jumps. And that's when my shoe ripped a hole in one of three layers.
I came in the middle for you. It's the middle for you, da behandelt, weißt du das?
Wie? Das dürfte nur zweilagig sein.
Ach so. Ich will dieses Mal eben zum Empfang gehen. Under normal circumstances, that is not going to happen.
We showed the sequence to our U of M professor for analysis.
Where I think the surprise came was in the actual tear. The material is known in the industry as being very tear resistant. And so puncture or tear is a very unfortunate surprise.
Professor Brownell pointed us to what appears to be one known weakness ETFE has: hail. Peter Fleur, a polymer consultant in Europe, has researched two ETFE failures due to hailstorms. In one storm, all air cushions of the roof except the front and the sides had to be replaced.
There is hail that can damage a roof, but throughout our whole career, which is about 1,000 buildings, we've had two cases of hail damage.
Vector Foiltec's founder did admit, when I tore a hole in it with my shoe, that sharp objects like hail do pose problems for this material.
A knife and foil go together as well as a hammer and glass.
Which begs the billion-dollar question. If a hailstorm damages the roof of the new Viking Stadium, who pays for it?
We've got, you know, so many redundancies built into it. We've got the steel structure that's holding it up. It's a three-panel system that is in place, and those panels can be replaced and repaired. So again, you know, what would be termed a system failure, you know, I think is open to question.
The facilities authority chair went on to say that she believes that in the case of roof failure, any damage not covered by a warranty would be picked up by insurance, but stands by the structure.
And the MSFA says that the roof has a 15-year warranty, no exclusions. Its insurance company estimates a deductible for a damage claim would be anywhere between $50,000 and $100,000. Okay, we want to bring in Dave Dahl now. We want to talk more specifics about some of the hail we see in the Twin Cities. Chris referenced one hailstorm with baseball-size hail.
Yeah, that does a lot of damage no matter to what.
Right. So how about the golf ball-size hail and jagged edges we were talking about there?
Yeah, golf ball-size hail occurs only here in the Twin Cities about once every 1 to 2 years, so about a year and a half.
Okay.
And that hail, a lot of times the impact side of the hail is actually smooth. The ragged edges are caused by rain droplets freezing along that actual ice ball. As it's falling through the atmosphere, it gets the jagged edges on the edge and not on the impact side. So, I don't think they'll be dealing with a lot of jagged hail.
Right.
But if that would be the problem, I would think that would cut the surface.
All right. Well, we're just going to have to wait and see what happens here these Minnesota winters.
Thankfully, it doesn't happen that often.
Right. Good. Yeah. Good to know. Thank you, Dave. All right.